Spider-Man and Batman.
Spider-Man, firefighters.
Green Lantern.
Ninja Turtles. Batman.
Spider-Man.
Spider-Man. Doctors?
I don't know. Yeah, that kind of thing.
Batman. Spider-Man.
I think any firefighter specifically could be a hero. Like, I wouldn't obviously know all their names, but, you know, they do the day-to-day job that we can only possibly imagine.
Some heroes. A mother, a father, a brother, a sister. Superman.
Yes.
Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction, sorcerers of death's construction. In the fields the bodies burning, as the war machine keeps turning. Death and hatred to mankind, poisoning their brainwashed
decades, people have wondered what the secrets of Area 51 are. UFOs, aliens, yetis, time machines, teleporters, doomsday devices, death rays, and the socks that go missing in the dryer. Though none of these have ever been confirmed, one project has finally come to surface. Area 51's self-proclaimed number one weapon, Bill. Born William in Area 51, New Mexico, USA, under strange circumstances. Not as successful as his sister, Bill possesses many abilities of his own. After many years of dragging down the team, Bill was kicked out of the then-named the Powerpuff Gang, later renamed the Powerpuff Girls. The girls hit it big soon after Bill's departure. Bill had an awkward adolescence, often trying to rebel by listening to non-standard issue music and movies such as the Bee Gees, Glenn Beck, and Cher. He bummed around Europe for a while after graduating from Area 51 University, where he played on the football team, the Area 51s. While in Europe, Bill worked as a taco vendor for extra money, a job that would help him hone his powers. Not much is known about Bill for the past 10 years, as he is presumed to have returned to Area 51 to hide. Until now. Tell us a little about yourself.
What exactly should I say?
Anything you feel comfortable with.
Well, being born from chemicals, I never really had much of a normal childhood. I was mainly raised by soldiers, scientists. Tell you one thing, those scientists may be able to make time machines and death rays, but there's just one thing they can't do. Change a diaper.
Can you demonstrate some of your powers?
Sure, okay. Watch this. One. immobile. Oh.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, impressive, eh? Number two. Invisobill. Hey, this is pretty good, eh? Yeah. Hey, bet you didn't know I was here. Taybill. Taco Bill.
To me, a hero is a very strong man who hits people and puts them in the hospital. Like Batman to the Joker.
Hero to me means someone who can put themselves before others in a life or death situation, or if it comes to any ordinary problem. Or to someone who could be an inspiration to others.
To me, a hero is a large man in a cape who flies around and saves people from time to time.
A hero is someone superior than a human being who is just so great at activities and being so positive and just saving the world and making a better change.
A hero to me means somebody that displays courage, and stereotypically they're really strong people, but I don't think you have to necessarily have the most strength in the world to be a hero. So, like, is a really responsible person.
A hero to me is someone who saves and changes lives. Someone who inspires and brings joy to someone's life.
Someone who saves the day?
I don't really know. I guess he's someone who like helps out other people, kind of saves people.
Work got a little slow, so I had to take a job working for a big time organization.
So what do you do at this office?
Oh, I'm a big shot down there. I manage big time accounts. I mean huge.
Hey, Bill. More coffee set for me?
Sure.
Thanks, bud.
Also, I... stable.
So that's all you do?
Yep. That's life of a hot commodity in the commodities business.
So tell me about this, Steve McCoy.
McCoy.
I presume you don't like this, Steve McCoy?
Steve McCoy is my arch nemesis. I've been battling an epic battle with him for years.
So I can presume you don't like this, Steve McCoy?
I hate him.
So what are your thoughts about Bill?
Pretty good when you get to know him.
So what's the spark that started this whole feud?
Years back, I had brought to the office a 14-course gourmet meal, which I had worked for 14 long months preparing at my home. I labeled it and placed it in the fridge. I was naive in my young days, believing that I could leave such a beautiful masterpiece alone in the office with Steve McCoy around. When I returned, it was no more. It was clearly labeled. Clearly labeled!
It was definitely not labeled. You have to hear the real story. Bill, he tends to exaggerate a lot. It was last week, the day of our annual potluck lunch. I was looking in the fridge to see if there's anything that hadn't been put out yet. I saw this gourmet meal and just presumed it was for the lunch. Like, who eats like a whole like 14-course meal for lunch?